Hello, everybody. What skill should I master? Welcome to my Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls. I'm on the Xbox One. Let's play, I guess. Playing as Thrill House. This isn't a drink along like you may be used to for a normal Let's Play for this site, but I gotta figure out something to do. I gotta start fucking making random ass commentaries like I used to do all the time with Dan, and now that he's not working for the site, oh, what happened to my TP to get back home? I gotta do something because I fucking love doing the drink-alongs, and even though I'm not drinking for the month, which I will get into more details for later, I still want to make more Let's Plays and stuff, and especially because you guys have been asking for them. Anyway, so Blizzard sent me a copy of this game early, which is fucking awesome, but it's really weird at the same time because I have no clue how they got my mailing address. They never asked for my mailing address. So the first review copy of anything I've ever got from Blizzard was just a couple months ago. For this, actually, for Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls on the PC. They just emailed it to me completely out of the blue. I don't know how I showed up on their review list. I mean, like, getting on a review list is a pretty fucking prestigious thing for any company, especially Blizzard. Like, Blizzard's, I mean, they make the best games around. I have no idea how I just randomly ended up on their review copy list, but I did. And I was like, holy shit, this is a big step forward. And then this just showed up in the mail completely out of the blue. And I was like, all right, fuck it, let's make some videos. So I played the shit out of Diablo 2 back in the day. I loved Diablo 2. I played it so much, man. Like, and oh man, like, oh, so many people, so many friends that I've talked to that are my age that like grew up playing games that kind of, I don't know, maybe moved on a little bit since. Like Diablo, like everybody's played Diablo, and I think I was a little bit disappointed by Diablo 3. Like I was just kind of bored with it. Like it wasn't, I don't know, it just didn't captivate me in the way that Diablo 2 did, or maybe I'm just older and not as interested in it as I used to be, but fuck, it just, like, I wanted it to be so good and I just got bored with it. So the first Diablo pack, I guess you can call it, I got a one of the archers, I don't even remember what the class is called, up to the max level and beat the game, and or yeah, I think I got it to the max level and beat the game. And now that I'm on the Xbox One, I had to recreate my character and start over, which is kind of a pain. But whatever. But I'm actually like really, really liking this game. Just playing with the console, just kind of more casually, just kind of sitting back a little bit, just taking my time. And of course, the barrel roll move. It seems stupid, but it actually makes a huge amount of difference in the game because, like, and I'll show you when I have an opportunity, but normally when you're playing on the PC, you have to like manually attack every single barrel that you want to like destroy. But with the barrel roll, it does one damage when you roll through people. And so you can use that to destroy five barrels at once. So it removes a lot of the tedium from destroying items in the environment. Yeah, like fucking hell, like Diablo 2, like getting the map pack going and Pindlebox and all that shit. Like I cheated so much on that game. I don't know if that's even possible in this game. I'm sure it is, but they probably catch you pretty quick. Probably not worth cheating on this game. So, anyway, I've been back in Colorado for a bit now. I moved into a new house. And I'm doing. So, even though. Yellow item. What is this? Teaming bracer. So, this is the new quick equip system. Oh shit, where are these guys coming from? Ah, so that right there is a perfect example of how I'm going to be doing these. Let's play drunks, or whatever I'm gonna call them, a little bit different than how I've been doing them before. I'm just gonna edit out sections where the commentary just kind of dies off because I'm fighting a boss and I need to focus, or I get distracted and have to answer my phone or something like that. So I'm gonna try to have these a little bit more, focused, I think is the best way to put it. But anyway, so I was saying, well, if you guys haven't followed the site too closely in the last couple months or so, Dan is no longer working for the site. I'm doing this by myself, or at least I'm the only one doing it full time. Dan has launched an iPhone app called WeVent. If you want to look it up, it's on the iPhone store right now. It's still kind of in a beginning stages, I think he would say. It's not really ready for mass consumption yet, but if you want to see how it's going, just look up on the iPhone store, WeVent. It's a photo sharing app. I'm not involved with it at all in any way, and I'm just doing this full time. Anyway, so I will be having guests on and such, but for the moment, it's just me. So anyway, the reason I'm not drinking on this Let's Play drunk is because even though Dan and I have parted ways, we are still friends, and he suggested doing this challenge called the Nob Nom Challenge, and N-O-B-N-O-M, no booze, no masturbation for a month, which has been incredibly difficult to do. We started it on August 1st, and it's August 18th right now. Yeah, and it has been incredibly, incredibly difficult to do. So the inspiration for this challenge was the author Tim Ferriss. He's written a couple books that have had very, very large influences on my life, and he's an active blogger and podcaster and everything too. He's written, his first book was called The 4-Hour Work Week, and then he came out with The 4-Hour Body, and then The 4-Hour Chef. And they're all great books. They all speak to me. I'm 28 and they fucking speak right to me, and especially The 4-Hour Work Week, I've read twice. I reread again recently, and it has a lot of great advice for like running a business and how to make your business a lifestyle and how to do something like play video games, a respectable thing, I think. Anyway, so he wrote this blog post about how basically dudes of my age, we have problems with booze and we have problems with jerking off too much. And I know that that's been a problem. Well, I don't know if it's been a problem for me, but it's been something that's been a part of my life for a long time, booze and jerking off. And then basically his argument was that, like, well, I mean, if you just get in your mind, you have this mindset of, well, I'm just going to go home, like, every night I'm just going to have a couple drinks and then go to sleep. You don't realize how much that adds up over time. And even though I'm 18 days in, I haven't lost I've lost maybe like 3 pounds doing this in 18 days, which isn't very much, but I'm in pretty fucking good shape right now, considering I just ran my first marathon about a month ago. My queen. Anyway, but I took for granted how often I woke up with a hangover. I mean, I was drinking heavily, maybe 5 nights a week, maybe more sometimes. Like, I probably haven't gone a week without drinking and getting drunk, like a solid week since I was 16. And for those of you that don't live in the U.S., 21 is the drinking age here. So, I mean, basically since I've been young, very young, I've been drinking like the prohibition was about to start. And I mean, just it's been really, really fucking hard not to drink in social situations. That's been the most difficult part of this whole thing, by a long shot, is not drinking in social situations. Like, I had to go to a 10-year high school reunion where there was an open bar and not drink. I had to go to a wedding for a friend that I've had since high school and not drink. Oh Christ, I might die here. And I went to a concert and didn't drink. I did do some heavy drugs at this concert. Actually, I wouldn't consider them heavy drugs. I would just say they are drugs. Pretty Lights show, which is kind of like an EDM electronic music show. So you can probably guess what I took there. Anyway, so, I mean, like, events like that, it's incredibly difficult, and it's been a good personal challenge. I'm really glad Dan suggested doing this challenge, and the reason he suggested doing this challenge to me and didn't just do this on his own is because we bet each other $100 to hold each other accountable on the honor system, so that if I went out and had a single drink, and I'm not talking about getting drunk, I'm talking about a sip of alcohol. If I have a sip of alcohol, I lose this bet, and if neither of us jerks it or has a sip for the entire month, then we both keep our money. But if one of us fails, then it's over. So for the no masturbation part, that doesn't include having sex. And I'm single right now, and I have got laid this month, but I don't have a girlfriend. So it's like, so that's the other part of his, of the original inspiration for this challenge is,
I believe the Archbishop has
magically bound some of guys of my age who have grown up with porn, it's just kind of like, all right, well, I'm going to jerk off and go to sleep tonight. But if you don't have that in the back of your mind as an option, it really forces you to work harder when you're out. And I thought it was kind of bullshit when I read it, but I was like, fuck it, why not? The idea... I honestly thought that the no booze was going to be the harder part of this challenge, but that has not been the case at all. Not jerking it has been much, much, much harder. Oh my god. Get back here. Oh, that's a great skill. And then roll past him for extra damage. Get back here, you fucking goblin. Give me your gold. Oh, almost got him. Get back here. Yeah, fuck off.
I'm overburdened.
Overburdened? Really? I didn't... Huh, I guess it's been a while. Alright, I'm gonna edit this out. Cool, so I got some new equipment and dropped off a whole bunch of other crap. I forgot to basically go back and sell all that before. But anyway, so that's the new style for this. And try to make these a little bit more concise and not just... Well, I mean, ramble like I always used to, but... I don't know, try not to have so many dead points. So anyway, not jerking it has been by far the hardest part of this challenge, which is, you know, like I was just saying, not what I expected. I didn't realize how much I relied on it, and I didn't realize how much it fucking sucks to not do it. And guys of my age, you kind of grew up on crazy hardcore porn, and I think it kind of gets in the back of your mind that it's always there when you go home, whether you're by yourself or, just by yourself. And it's like, I don't know. I think it fucked me up. I probably watched too much porn over the years. So anyway, I'm really glad I'm doing this challenge. I mean, like when he suggested this thing and I read the article that kind of explained the whole point of the challenge, I realized, I don't want to do this. This sounds way too fucking hard. No booze for a month, especially in a month where I have a 10-year high school reunion and a wedding. And just like, as soon, and like football games and soccer games and like, you know, the Broncos preseason starting and all these other things. And it's like, as soon as you have in your mind this idea of, oh, I can't drink, and you instantly, and like people start asking you, oh, you want to do this weekend? You want to go to a show this night? Or you want to go to a Rapids game? Or you want to go to a Broncos preseason game? And you're like, every single one of these things, I quickly realized that there was about 15 different events before the month even started that were on my calendar that I was going to drink at. And probably every single one of those days, I was going to be hungover, or the next day at least. And I was like, I quickly realized, like, my whole life is based around booze. I mean, whoops. And especially with like the drink-alongs and live streaming and stuff like that. I mean, I was taking shots for subscribers, and there would be days where I'd be streaming at 5-6 o'clock in the afternoon here in Denver, and I would have 4 or 5 shots in the middle of the day. And it's like, that's not a good way to go about your day-to-day life. So I need to figure out how I'm going to adjust the stream accordingly, but also like how I'm going to have, like, I'm really glad I did this challenge, even though the booze is the hardest part. Like, I know I wasn't an alcoholic because I haven't had DTs or anything crazy like that after not drinking, but I quickly realized like how much of an enormous influence booze has had on my day-to-day life. And I don't think that's a good thing, and I know that after this month that my day-to-day drinking will go down. It absolutely will go down. And it's just crazy, like, I've probably, like, in social situations, I've spent more time drunk than sober. And especially since I turned 21, ooh, new badass weapon. Oops. Equip. Hell yeah. Chop infection. That's a badass name. I spend, like, I pregame before every time I would go out to the bars. Or, and, like, if I was going to tailgate for a Broncos game or something, I would have a couple drinks beforehand. And that's not, like, every time I would go out to the bars, I would already be drunk because I didn't want to spend money at the bars. And then I'll just have a couple shots or a couple drinks at the bars. Even. And it's like, in retrospect, I don't know what the, like, I was never an alcoholic. I was never addicted. But I don't think I could have said no in a lot of situations. And I had to have some excuse, like, I'm not drinking for a whole month, to realize that, to say no. And that's kind of scary. Another nice thing about it is, a really nice fucking thing about it is, I've had bad heartburn my entire life. Or not my entire life, yeah, since I was maybe 20, something like that. I've been taking heartburn medication regularly, like ranitidine or triazolam or you know, Prozac equivalents, basically. And I now realize that, like, not drinking, I have almost no heartburn. All my heartburn every night and every day that I would ever have was from booze. And I eat really, really healthy now that I've completed a marathon, and I have no heartburn now. So I don't know. I wonder if it's going to come back after I start drinking again at the end of the month or what. I do know exactly the day that it's going to be the first drink that I have. I believe it is August 29th. Oh, another treasure goblin. I will be in Seattle for PAX Prime. And Twitch sent out an invite to all their partners. They said, and it's an invite-only thing, and for the first couple hours it's invite-only, and then eventually it's going to be open. Ooh, a new shield. Equip. Evil lurks in many places. So they sent out an invite. It's an open bar event at some place by the convention center, and it's August 29th, and that is going to be the last day of the thing, and I can't fucking wait for a drink, and I know I'm going to get absolutely shit-faced after just one drink, which is going to be fun too, because my tolerance was ridiculous, through the roof. Like, I could drink anybody under the table for a long time, and I know that's not going to be the case anymore, which is kind of nice, because it's going to be cheaper to get drunk, especially at a free open bar. But, So, booze has completely won my life for a long time. I mean, just look at the stuff that we did on the channel. Everything was this drinking, that drinking, turning everything into a drinking game, or, you know, shots for subs. I mean, my life is video games and booze. That's not healthy. Even though I exercise a lot, spending that much time doing video games and booze, something's gotta give. And it's stressing me the fuck out just talking about it this much, and I wanna drink just talking about it. The nights are really fucking difficult. Going to sleep, not jerking off, and not having a drink, it's really fucking hard to get to sleep. That's been the craziest thing. And nights are fucking boring. Like, it's really boring not drinking. I'm gonna go back to drinking instantly. I think it'll be in a more responsible way. I used to drink and drive a lot. Especially when I was living in the suburbs and the bars are always a mile away. I would drink and drive frequently. But I don't do that anymore, living closer to the city. I will never do that anymore. I'm sure it'll come up every once in a while. I mean, I'm no saint, but fuck. It's just saying that, I realize how terrible of a person I am. I think I'll still be drinking and driving every once in a while. I mean, it's inevitable. You kind of have to. Actually, no, that's not true. Living in the city, there's always cabs and stuff like that, but... God, like, the nights are really fucking boring. Just on an average Tuesday night, I, like tonight, Monday night, it's 10:30. I want a vodka tonic so goddamn bad right now. Just to help me, just to take the edge off and go to sleep. And it would, oh my God, that sounds so nice just to go to sleep. I've been taking a lot of sleeping medications since not drinking booze. I have some heavy prescribed sleeping stuff. What the hell? Feel her loving embrace. Blah. What the fuck was that? Did I just get ambushed? I have some like heavy sleeping pills and just like Tylenol PM, painkillers and stuff like that. Not painkillers. But pain relief PM pills and stuff like that. And I also, through Tim Ferriss's 4-Hour Body, found out about this this stuff that you can just get on Amazon. It's called California Poppy Extract. And if you've ever watched Game of Thrones, you probably remember them talking about milk of the poppy and using that to go to sleep. And it puts you to fucking sleep. It's this weird little vial of stuff. You take a little eyedropper and you put 20 to 30 drops of it in a glass of water, and it knocks you, whoa, and it knocks you the fuck out. It's insane how quickly it works and how you can buy this stuff on Amazon. And how well it works. How well, like, it's, I hope it's not happening for me. I should probably look into that before continuing to take it, but I've taken it quite a bit this month, and it really works, and I really like it. It smells like shit and tastes like shit, but it's very, very effective. Where'd you go? I do not remember what the pattern for this boss is. Ah, killed the fucking great queen spider. Items, items, items. All right, so anyway, I think that's a pretty good Let's Play Drunk, even though this one's fucking sober. That's probably not a good name. I'll just call this one a Let's Play. Pool of Venom. Delicious. What the fuck was that? Nothing? All right. Ah, cool. Anyway, so thanks for watching, and let me know what you think about this new kind of format for these Let's Plays or whatever I'm going to be calling these things going forward. Game on.